the movie ride. I'm going to the movies. The movies. Gaming with Kev, what is up, my family? We are back and we are on the scary rides, guys. The scary story ride. If y'all remember, we did the golden arm. We did this story before, guys. If y'all didn't see that video, though, that link is going to be at the top of my description box. The developer hit your boy up and said, I got two more stories. Two new stories. The Passenger and Hide and Seek. So we're going to do both of these stories right now, guys. And we're starting off with Hide and Seek. Shocking. OMG, no. Never playing that game again. And then we're going to The Passenger. Let's get it, baby. Good evening. This way, please. Enjoy the show. Thank you. Well, hello there. What's up, my girl? She looking a little beautiful. I love the eyes. You're looking like Kylie Jenner, my girl. Hello, you already purchased your ticket. You may enter on the side of the ticket booth. Enjoy the show. Or thank you. Good evening. This way, please. Enjoy the show. Seems like everybody's telling me to enjoy the show. I hope I enjoy the show. Be sure to smash that thumbs up button, guys, for more stories. We have to show the developer that we want more stories. We need over 10,000 likes right now. My boy, I love the mustache. Good evening. Right through the doors, please. Enjoy the show. Everybody's telling me to enjoy the show. Oh, man. Here we go, guys. Oh, hide and seek. So you guys know we're on a conveyor right now. Dan and Melanie were getting married in a week, so they invited their best friends over to Melanie's house for a party. Okay, so everybody partying over here. What y'all got? Y'all got some chips out? Some soda? Nice, some pretzels. Everybody's just happy. I like that sweater, my boy. Kind of look like Freddy Krueger, but it's nice. Everybody's happy. Look, she's like laughing like, you're so funny. And my boy, where's your pants at? Where your pants at, man? And my boy, where's your pants at? Really? You got your booty cheeks all out, man. Well, let's get this party started, baby. Okay, I wasn't invited to the party. All right, okay. We'll go to the next scene. Melanie still lived in her childhood home, which was always their favorite place to hang out since they were kids. And they're still just having some fun. Some nice fun, guys. Everybody's still happy. They all started talking about their favorite childhood game, hide and seek. Oh, so this is when it takes a turn. They're all standing around, guys, talking about hide and seek. Everybody's still happy, though. Everybody's still smiling. Okay, so what are we gonna do, guys? Are we all gonna play hide and seek together? My boy, you need another edge up. What did the barber do to you? My boy got the McDonald's logo. Dang! They decided they just had to play the game. And Dan was picked to be the seeker. So is this Dan? Because he has his eyes closed and he has like his hand on my boy's shoulder right here. So, or is he the seeker? Is that Dan? Dan began counting to 100 as everyone ran from the room to hide. Oh, so this is Dan. Okay, so he's counting, guys. Dan is counting to 100. Everybody's running. He's like, hey, come on, let's go. Let's go hide. Hurry up before he gets to 100. They're like, yay, hide and seek. Oh, my God, oh, my God, oh, my God. So everybody's just so excited to play hide and seek, guys. Dan finished counting. Ready or not, here I come, he yelled loudly. He went through the house looking for all his friends. Oh, so my boy is going door to door, guys. Hey, Dan, you need some help, my boy? Because I can go in there, you know what I'm saying? Or maybe I can check this one. So he's looking around right now, trying to find his friends. He looked everywhere, but was having a hard time finding anyone. Oh, man, let me see his face. Oh, he's still smiling, though. He's still pretty happy. I like the zip-up shoes. Wow, that's different, Dan. I like those. He finally found Gerald in the kitchen pantry eating pretzels. So Gerald was, he wasn't even hiding. My boy was in there getting down in the pantry. He got the pretzels right there. He's so happy. Oh my God, yes, I found Gerald. Gerald's like, I don't even care, man. These pretzels are so bomb. Dan and Gerald went back to the living room and yelled for everyone to come out. Okay, guys, game's over. Everybody come back. Come back to the living room. Everyone came running back into the living room. they were having so much fun. Look, everybody's all happy. They all came back, guys. They all started talking about where they were hiding. They laughed and laughed. Oh. After a few minutes, they noticed that Melanie wasn't there. Oh, look at their faces. So where is Melanie? Melanie! Melanie, where are you? Everyone began shouting her name. See, I'm right on point. Melanie! You can come out now! But there was no answer. Oh, man. Oh, they're all frightened, guys. Melanie, where are you? They were all getting nervous now. Okay, let's split up and look for her, Dan said. They all agreed and went to look for Melanie. Okay, so they all split up. They searched every square inch of the house, but could not find Melanie. Oh, this is getting too creepy. Okay, so it looks like someone's looking under the bed there. No Melanie. My boy's all in the kitchen, looking in the cabinets, in the sink, behind the counter. Still no Melanie, guys. Gerald and Grace even looked in the attic, but Melanie was nowhere to be found. Oh, that's creepy. Now that's creepy. Melanie's parents just got home from their night out. Dan told them everything. Oh, look at her mom. Wow, Pops is looking nice. Jeez, mom too, you look beautiful. You guys look great. Hope dinner was great, jeez, man. But still no Melanie, guys. And they're huddled up over here like, look guys, we have to find Melanie. Man, everyone's just scared. Oh, an hour had already passed, so Melanie's parents decided to call the police. Dan's crying right here, guys. They're trying to they're trying to be there for him, but we don't know where Melanie is. Like, oh my gosh. The police searched the entire property and questioned everybody, but there was no sign of Melanie anywhere. Oh, so we got the popo here. They're questioning everybody, guys. Mom is still freaking out. Dad's looking pretty sad. This is getting crazy. Where is Melanie? Melanie, where are you, my girl? Where are you? They made a full report and put out an APB, but said there was nothing else they could do at this time. They slowly left the house. So they put the APB out, guys, and then the police took off. I guess they're just gonna play the waiting game and see if Melanie just happens to appear again. No one ever saw or heard from Melanie again. Dan blamed himself, thinking that maybe Melanie just didn't want to marry him, so perhaps she ran away. And look, he's so sad. He's crying over here, guys. He's blaming himself. He thinks that Melanie does not want to be with him. Dan, I believe she wants to be with you, bro. Wipe your tears, Dan. 15 years later, Dan was a very successful architect, but never got over Melanie. Dang, my boy got the beard now and everything, but he's still sad, guys. Still thinking about Melanie. 15 years later, man, this is crazy. Then one day, Dan's mother called him. She told him that Melanie's parents were selling the house. Oh, he's on the phone. He's on the phone with his mama. His heart was broken, but then she told him something terrible. I wonder what that was. She told him that when Melanie's parents brought in a moving company to pack up all their things, they found something. Oh my gosh, what did they find? In the basement, they found a very heavy trunk. And when Melanie's parents unlocked it and opened it, they found Melanie inside. That was where she was hiding. The trunk lid must have locked when she got inside. Oh, look at his face. He's like, what? Are you serious? All I had to do was open up the trunk. Dan collapsed and began to cry. The one place they did not check was the basement. Why wouldn't they check the basement, guys? What is wrong with them? No one had ever hid there before. Oh, he's crying, guys. He's crying. He is heartbroken. Dan imagined poor Melanie calling out for help inside the trunk. Dan, help me. Dan. But Dan never came because he couldn't hear her. Man, I'm starting to really feel sad for Dan. All he wanted to do was marry her. Dan has nightmares about Melanie and the trunk all the time. He can hear her screaming for him to help her. Oh, look at the trunk. There's a trunk right there, guys. In the basement. Oh! For real? For real? Really? Don't forget to visit our other attractions. Really? Just go jump scare your boy like that. So the next one is the passenger, guys. Man, this one was crazy. So all they had to do was go into the basement and look in the trunk. That's it. Or they at least would have heard her screaming out. Dad! Oh man, this is crazy. Jeez. We hope you enjoyed the show. You can step through the doors to re-enter the theater. I don't know if I want to re-enter the theater. Oh! What do you guys think about that story, guys? Hide and seek. Now, I love hide and seek. It's one of my favorite games to play, especially as a kid growing up. But it looks like Melanie went into the basement and tried to hide in the trunk. And it may have locked itself. Maybe the trunk was haunted and kept Melanie in there, but nobody went into the basement. Dan was never the same after that, guys. Even though he became a successful architect, he was never the same. We've done hide and seek, guys. We've done the golden arm, but we've never done the passenger. So creepy. Talk about chills. No way. Totally creeped me out. And look at her. Look how she's standing right there. Are you guys ready for this? Be sure to smash that thumbs up button for more stories coming soon. The Babysitter. Y'all better get that thumbs up button up there, baby. If y'all want me to do The Babysitter and I See You. Oh my gosh, She's Not Alone. And this one says, I dropped my phone. Scariest thing ever. So scary. I am so scared right now. I see you. And I see you. All right, guys, here we go. Jeez, I just love this theater. So beautiful. Hey, buddy, how you doing? All right. This is when everything gets creepy all of a sudden. All right, we're going through the entrance, guys. Oh, man. The passenger. Jeez. Maggie was so excited about going to her senior dance at the high school. She could hardly contain herself. Look at Maggie. She's in here getting all dressed, looking all beautiful for her high school dance. I like the pink and the flower skirt. That is nice. Oh, and look at this room. Flowers everywhere. Jeez, Maggie. I see you, my girl. So she's getting dressed right now, guys. Just so excited to go to her high school dance. As soon as she was ready, she grabbed her sweater and ran out front. The girls will be by to pick her up soon. Oh, man. It's so dark out there. Look at that. Maggie, maybe you should have waited inside the house until the girls got there to pick you up. But being out here and it's just a little too creepy for your boy. You know what I'm saying? Like, you need to be in the house. Before she knew it, the girls were there. She jumped into the car and off they went. That's a nice car. Jeez. And all the girls are just so happy. Look at them, guys. Look at her in the back. Jeez, look at that face. She is so happy to go to the dance. I hope you girls have fun if you make it there. Ah, well, it looks like they made it. Everyone was so excited. They rushed into the school and went straight to the gymnasium to see the decorations. Whoa, look at this cool guy. He's with his girlfriend. He's like, yeah, about to go get my dance on, baby. Get my dance on. I love those glasses, man. Those shades are nice. Oh, look at you looking all spiffy. And look at you, my girl. Wow, everybody's looking rather nice. Oh, you two are matching pretty much. Like his and her outfits. Wow. Okay. I wish I had somebody to go to the dance with. Will one of you guys come with me to the dance? Let your boy know in a comment below. The decorations were wonderful and everyone was having a great time. Wow. Talk about a high school dance. This is awesome. They have a band up here as well. Jeez, my boy is singing his heart out up here. He has his eyes closed, guys, just singing his heart out. And this guy has a little smirk on his face like, hey, leave me alone. I'm just playing my guitar. I love the balloons. Don't like the red one, though. That makes me think about It the Clown. But this is popping, baby. Party! Party! Your boy wants some juice, too. I need a little bit of this punch. Thank you. Appreciate it. Why is my boy standing by himself over here, though? But after a while, Maggie found herself alone. No one asked her to dance or paid attention to her. Aw, Maggie's sad, guys. Everybody's just dancing and enjoying themselves, and nobody asked Maggie to dance. Well, Maggie, you can dance with me if you want to. I'll dance with you. Maggie decided to leave the dance and walk home alone. No, that's a terrible idea, Maggie. Trust me. Jeez. I already didn't want her outside of her house before the girls came and picked her up. Now she's back outside into this crazy, scary darkness, and she wants to walk home alone. Super bad idea. Maggie never felt so alone. The walk was long and scary. I said that. I said it's too scary. Like, why are you? Look at this. Like, why would you do that, Maggie? Such a bad idea, but she was sad, guys. She was sad, so she didn't even care. As Maggie began to cross the town bridge, a car came racing past, almost hitting her. Wow, slow down, buddy. Jeez, love the car though, but you almost freaking hit Maggie. By the time Maggie crossed the bridge, she was feeling very sick. She sat down on a log for a rest. Man, I want to kind of check around here and see if, you know, any monsters or anything, you know. What is this in her hand, though? Like, what is that, Maggie? She's so sad. She's actually making me pretty sad, I'm gonna be honest. After a few minutes, another car pulled up and stopped. A man got out and walked over to Maggie to check on her. Oh, gosh. Okay, so he pulled up. He walked over to check on Maggie. I don't like where this is going. She told him she wasn't feeling well, so he would drive her home if she wanted. She accepted and got into the car. Oh man, you shouldn't have did that, Maggie. She got into a car with a stranger. You never get into any cars or anything with a stranger. She told him about the dance and what had happened. He tried to cheer her up as best he could. He was a very nice man. Even though he's nice, he's still a stranger, Maggie. So he's taking her home, I think. I'm not sure. Hopefully he's just gonna take her home. Soon Maggie was home and the man wished her well and told her to feel better. Maggie thanked him and he drove off. So he did take her home, guys, and he's smiling. She's waving him by. She's like, thanks for cheering me up. I appreciate it. After the man got home, he realized that Maggie had left her sweater in the car. Okay, so that's what she was holding. She was holding her sweater that whole time, and he realized, hey, Maggie left her sweater in my car. Now, is he gonna take it back to her? We don't know. We're about to see. He thought he would drop it off in the morning on his way to work since it was too late at night now. Okay, so he's going in the house, guys. He's calling it a night. I'm going to bed. When I go to work in the morning, I'll just drop it off to Maggie. Sounds about right. That's pretty cool. Next morning, the man went to Maggie's house to drop off the sweater. An old woman answered the door. Oh, and she answered with a sad face too, guys. And he's still smiling. Sad smile. Sad smile. So I wonder who this mysterious old woman is, guys, who answered the door. He told her he had given Maggie a ride the night before and that she had left her sweater in the car. So he's passing it over to the older woman there, giving her the sweater, like, hey, can you get this back to Maggie? She looked very sad and stared at the sweater. This is Maggie's sweater, all right. She took it to the high school dance with her. But why is she looking very sad? Like, what's going on here? Like, I don't know what's about to happen. But whoever you drove home last night wasn't Maggie. Maggie died when she was hit by a speeding car on the town bridge, but that was over 50 years ago. What? Even his face. He's like, what? What are you talking about? I just took Maggie home last night. I was just bringing her sweater back 50 years ago. Oh! Do not scare me like that, bro. Look at his face. He is startled. Oh! Is that Maggie? Maggie, is that you? Oh. So the passenger that he picked up, guys, was Maggie, but she died 50 years ago. So was that her ghost? Like, what was it? Did Maggie just want to, like, live out her high school dream of going to the dance? And, like, I don't know. What do you guys think? Leave a comment below. We need more scary story rides, baby. Wow, that was so creepy. The whole time, it wasn't even Maggie, or it was Maggie's ghost. Wow. If you guys want more scary stories, hey, we gotta show the developer that we want more, guys. Be sure to smash that thumbs up button right now for your boy. Subscribe for more gameplays just like this. Click that post notification bell. That way you guys are notified every time your boy G-Dub K uploads. And I will see you guys in the next video. I love y'all, man, from the bottom of my heart. As always, let me know how y'all like these stories below. Till next time, peace!